Hey everyone, now that Intel's 13th generation Raptor Lake CPU offerings and Z790 motherboards have been on the market for a couple of weeks, with gems such as the i5-13600K emerging as the undisputed value champion for a modern PC. Building a new PC on the LGA 1700 platform sure sounds like an attractive proposition, even though the Intel LGA 1700 platform will be end of life once the next generation of processors launch on a totally different socket. With this in mind, for today's video, we'll take a look at a more premium motherboard offering sporting the spanking new Intel Z790 chipset while still serving up DDR4 support, the Gigabyte Z790 AORUS Elite AX DDR4. Let's get started. As an offering from the AORUS series of products, this board is positioned as more of a premium offering targeted at folks looking to build a mid to high-end gaming PC, and it sits above the mid-tier Gigabyte Gaming series and the entry-level ultra-durable series of motherboards. No surprises then that the packaging comes with the AORUS logo emblazoned on the front for a more gamer-oriented appearance. Moving over to the rear of the box, we get the usual overview of specs for this board. We'll cover the board specs in depth in the next few minutes of this video. On a side note, if you're new to the ALK Tech channel, do consider subscribing so as to keep up to date with the latest developments in the PC hardware world. Let's set aside the board for the moment to see what accessories Gigabyte has included with the board. First up, we get a Wi-Fi antenna right here. And this is accompanied by two SATA 3 cables. We also do get a G connector attachment right here that simplifies the process of hooking up the front panel connectors of your PC case to the motherboard. And this is rounded off by a quick start guide right here. Here it is, the Z790 AORUS Elite AX DDR4. We see that Gigabyte has gone for a black and silver color scheme with these line motifs featuring predominantly on the heatsinks. I'd say that while the aesthetic of this board is pretty restrained as compared to the other gaming motherboards that can be found on the market, it still manages to look pretty premium in my opinion. As you can see, it comes with an integrated I/O shield design, and the VRM heatsinks for this board seem pretty decently sized. In terms of VRM specs, Gigabyte has included 16+1+2 power stages rated for up to 60 amps. The board comes with a passive heatsink for the Z790 chipset, and there are RGB LEDs included beneath the said chipset heatsink for added visual appeal. For M.2 drive cooling, Gigabyte's included a chunky heatsink for the primary M.2 slot here, and a common heatsink for the remaining three M.2 slots that this board comes with. For memory support, the Z790 AORUS Elite AX DDR4 comes with 4 DDR4 slots, not DDR5, with support for up to 128GB of RAM and the DDR4 5333 standard when overclocked, with plastic slots of a dual tab design. Further down from the RAM slots is a USB 3.2 Gen 1 front panel header that supports up to 2 USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports, and next to it, a USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-C front panel header. While still on the topic of USB connectivity, the bottom edge of the board houses two USB 2.0 front panel headers right here, with each header providing support for up to two USB 2.0 Type-A ports. Moving on to the special features that this board comes with, we get a Q-Flash Plus button right here that allows you to update the BIOS without needing to install a CPU, RAM, or graphics card. We also get a multi-key button that can be configured by end users within the BIOS so as to serve different functions, such as to serve as a reset switch, or even to control the RGB lighting effects of supported peripherals that are connected to the board. Moving further up, we get a clear CMOS button that allows you to do so without needing to remove the CMOS battery, a set of Thunderbolt headers that allow you to add a Thunderbolt add-on card that is sold separately by Gigabyte, as well as a set of LEDs right here that can help with troubleshooting PC issues while booting up. In terms of expansion slots, this board comes with a PCIe 5.0 x16 slot for a graphics card. The said slot comes with the PCIe Easy Latch feature that is essentially an oversized graphics card retention tab that helps make removing a graphics card from the board less of a painful affair. We also get two full-length PCIe 4.0 x16 slots that operate at X4 mode each. In the storage department, Gigabyte has included four SATA 3 ports with all four ports in a right-angled configuration so as to aid with cable management. For M.2 slots, it comes with four PCIe 4.0 X4 M.2 slots, with the first three slots here supporting NVMe M.2 drives only, and the fourth slot here supporting both NVMe and SATA M.2 drives. For audio, Gigabyte's gone with a Realtek audio codec that is paired with Chemicon and WiMA capacitors right here. Wired internet connectivity is courtesy of Realtek's RTL8125BG chip, which provides support for 2.5 gigabit Ethernet, and the board's Wi-Fi is powered by Intel's AX211 Wi-Fi module. It serves up Wi-Fi 6E and Bluetooth 5.3 support. In the cooling and RGB departments, the board comes with 6 fan headers which are in these regions of the board. Also included are two addressable RGB headers and two 12-volt standard RGB headers located right here. Moving over to the rear I/O, the Z790 AORUS Elite AX DDR4 goes for an integrated I/O shield design. The board comes with four USB 2.0 Type-A ports, Wi-Fi antenna connectors, two USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-A ports with this port here supporting the Q-Flash Plus feature, a HDMI 2.0 port that supports the 4K resolution at 60Hz, three USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports, a USB 3.2 Gen 2x2 Type-C port, a 2.5 Gigabit Ethernet port, as well as your usual audio jack connectors. In conclusion, the Gigabyte Z790 AORUS Elite AX DDR4 is a decent offering of an Intel Z790 DDR4 motherboard that is positioned at the higher end, where it serves up a decent VRM setup, a PCIe 5.0 x16 graphics card slot, plenty of M.2 drive slots and USB 3.2 connectivity options, 2.5 gigabit Ethernet, as well as Wi-Fi 6E. With the above in mind, one issue to think about is the value proposition that Intel Z790 boards can offer, especially since motherboards sporting the previous gen Intel Z690 and B660 chipsets are still available new on the market, can be had for likely cheaper prices, and more importantly, sport support for the latest 13th generation Raptor Lake processors while offering up similar feature sets. In addition, since the Z790 chipset has a minimal number of feature improvements over the Z690, it might be worth your while to check out 600 series motherboard offerings at least while they're still available new before committing to a purchase decision. With that, thank you so much for watching, hit the like button and get subscribed if you've enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys around the next time.